you create this image of Steve. At least I did. You read these books and you create this image of this amazing sort of iconic author in your mind, and you know, and you attach all of these amazing, profound characteristics to this person, and then you meet the person and you spend the day with them. Literally at the end of, like, I remember one shooting day, he was driving home with transportation and he was like, "Can we pull into McDonald's? I just want a fish fillet meal." And it's like, you eat fish fillets like you're Stephen King. You know,
the first time I met him, I was with Aisha. It was the first time I'd met Aisha too. And we walked out and I was like, "Oh my God, it's him. Okay, pull it together. It's fine. We'll just meet him. It's good." And I walked out and he looks at me and he goes, "I like your slippers." And I had like pink ballet flats on. And I was just like, oh thanks.
Oh my God. And the best one, he was... the one woman who played my wife, she was working out incessantly every morning in the gym, and we were all gym rats, you know, in the beginning of the production. And so he too was in the gym. And so he was in the gym one day, and then the next day we didn't see him in the gym. And so we saw him on set and we were like, "Hey, so you weren't in the gym," just making, you know, some chat. "So you weren't in the gym today." And he was like, "Oh no, I was down there. So she was like, "So I was like, so what did you do? Did you..." He was like, "You know, I did the treadmill a little bit." And I was like, "Did you lift some weights?" And he was like, "Oh, homie don't lift weights." And I was like, "Stephen King, did you just say homie don't lift weights?" And at that moment, I was like, Stephen is truly the homie.
He's also been known to say homie don't tweet. That was another one. I think that's his thing.
Yeah. So yeah, this amazing, amazing, profound, prolific writer is pretty down to earth and pretty funny.
Hysterical.